In today's English lesson, we are going to learn English at a lighthouse. Well, sort of. The first term we are going to learn today is no trespassing. Unfortunately, we can't get too close to that lighthouse because, as you saw, that sign said no trespassing on the island, which means we can't step foot on that island or we could get in trouble. We could probably get arrested. There is just a little bit of water in between the mainland, which is where I'm at. Like, it's the biggest part of the United States, we'd say the mainland, and this island. But I don't want to get in trouble, so I'm not going to cross over there. Do you see those things floating in the water over there? We would call them buoys. And most likely, there are some people that fish for lobster. We call them lobstermen. And they probably have traps down there. This is about as far as I want to go, but if you look on the rocks, there is seaweed. So we might say those rocks are covered with seaweed. It sounds like there are some people that aren't speaking English. Maybe it's Vietnamese. I will try to get close. Tell me if I'm right. Well, of course, you would have to speak Vietnamese to let me know if I'm right. No, it's not Vietnamese. I think it's Spanish. Look at this view. Please tell me in the comments, would you like to visit a place that looks like this? The next term I would love to teach you is a memorial bench. And that's not easy to say, a memorial bench. So it looks like this man named Richard Johnson probably passed away. It's a nice way to say they died. We'll often say that in English, they passed away. So his family remembers him. And that is the verb, remembers him, or has a memory, that's the noun, with this bench. So they probably paid to have this bench here. Who knows, they might come sit here on certain days and just remember him. The next term I would like to teach you is thorns. Watch this. Here are some thorns. If you touch those thorns, it will probably hurt. The next term I would like to teach you is rowboat, but we have to get over there first. But first, we will pass by a couple more memorial benches. I might say that they are a little low to the ground. Seems like it might be a little awkward to sit here. Well, maybe on this side. Yeah, not so bad, because you want to sit here and look out at the ocean. Did you know that phrasal verb, look out? It looks like we are currently facing east. Which means if I could see far enough, I would probably be looking somewhere towards France, maybe? England? So shout out to anyone who's watching from France. All right, looks like we're gonna have to find another way around. I don't think the dad shoes are going to be able to get us to that rowboat from this way. We can go around. All right, we're pretty close to the rowboat, so of course I need to try to sit in there, right? It's a little tipsy, we might say, but yeah, there we go. I'm now sitting in the rowboat.
Logan!
If you visit the United States and it's a historical place or where a lot of tourists will go, they will often have a visitor's center. That's what we're going to check out next. Actually, before we check out the visitor's center, I would like to teach you life preserver. Just in case you don't know life preserver, this is a life preserver. I called it a visitor center. This is actually a welcome center, and guess what? There's no difference. And to explain what these bells are and a little advanced English, we have a special guest, my wife, Jamie.
Hi everyone, welcome to Maine. So in the 1600s, they had these bells and they would ring very loudly when it was very low visibility or during a storm to let the ships know and the captains know that they were getting very close to what we call savage rocks on the shore. These were replaced by electric foghorns once electricity came to be in America. And then the foghorns would just blow really loudly to again let the ships know that there was low visibility that you would have a hard time seeing coming to shore.
Remember how we talked about you couldn't go on that island or it would be trespassing, that island right over there? Let's talk about raffle tickets. Raffle tickets. You can buy a raffle ticket for $10, and if they draw your name, if they pick your ticket, then you can spend the day on that island. Nubble Light. So looks like you can go on there for 4 hours. I just don't know when they are going to draw the ticket. It says ask a sales associate for more details. That means ask somebody inside who works there. This type of bird is called a puffin.
He's loved Nubble Light. Isn't that pretty?
And as you saw, this visitor center has a lot of souvenirs. It's what we call things you can take home to remember your trip. Souvenirs, they probably have a little information in there about the lighthouse. And they also have bathrooms, which is pretty important. I hope you've enjoyed this English lesson from a lighthouse. If you're looking for more English lessons from lighthouses, guess what? I have another one right up there. Thanks for watching. See you next time.